Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to talk to you about the Waves eMotion LV1 Classic expanding from 64 channels to 80 channels. That's 160 inputs, because remember, the LV1, every channel can either be mono or stereo. And the best part is, this is just available to us via a software upgrade up to the version 16 of the LV1 software, plus the license for the 80 channel expansion. But in this video, I want to actually dive in to see how this is done and what this actually gives us. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with the production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, on my console, I have upgraded this to version 16, and I have also gone in and added the 80 channel expansion. Now, version 16 is free for every LV1 Classic user, and then the 80 channel expansion is available through waves.com, which I'm going to link down in the description below on where to get the details for that. Now, once you have this set and you have installed the license and you have updated your console, then what we can do is we can go into setup, and then on our mixer settings, we now have 16 channels, we have 32 input channels, 64 channels, and then now we have two 80 input channels for our LV1 Classic mixer. Now, there's two of the settings for 80 input channels because there's two different types that we can pull up. And the main difference between these two is it has expanded the amount of auxes or expanded the amount of groups available to us on our LV1, which is fantastic. So if we select this first one, we can see that there would be 16 groups, 24 auxes, 3 mains, and 8 matrices. And then if we select the second one, we would have 8 groups, 32 auxes, 3 mains, and 8 matrices. Now, the main difference between these is, are you mixing for front of house or are you mixing with monitors? Now, if you're mixing with monitors, my suggestion is to go to the second one where you have 8 groups, you have 32 auxes, 3 mains, 8 matrices, and your main cue. If you're mixing for front of house and need more of those stereo groups for mixing, then you can do the 80 input channels. So let me go ahead and load up the first 80 input channels and we can check this out. Now, obviously, when we load this 80 input channels, our DSP is going to go up slightly because we've now added more channels and we've added more outputs for our bus structure of the actual console. But let's go take a look at mixer 1. So now I have my 1 through 16, 17 through 32, 33 through 48, 49 through 64. And at this point, our console would stop. But now we have another 16 channels available to us on our surface. Now, on top of this, if we go into our mixes, we have our 16 groups here, because remember, I loaded up that first one. And this is going to be perfect for those of you who are mixing front of house, because we have our 16 groups, we have our 8 effects, and then we have 16 monitor sends specifically set up in this scene. Now, because when I created this show file, I was actually using some of these monitors as subgroups, so I will obviously need to go change this and move these 8 over to my groups. But let's go check out the other one. So let's go to setup and we'll go to the other 80 input channels and we can check this one out. And so then I can go to mixer 1 and we can now see in my groups, I have my 8 groups here. We then have our 8 effects. And then on the monitors, I have my first 16 here, and then I have my 17 through 24. So for all of those who are using this as a monitor desk, or for those larger churches that maybe need this many auxes for outputs for different in-ears, for the band, wedges, different things like that, this is going to be a perfect setup for you. Now, one very big upgrade that is also included with version 16 is the DSP structure is actually more efficient. And you will find this DSP efficiency because version 16, they've programmed the DSP servers to be more efficient with the codec than in comparison to previous versions of SoundGrid. So this is not only going to give you your 80 channel expansion with more buses, but then also you're going to have more efficient DSP, meaning that you can add in more plugins or add in those extra channels when you need it. Now, another big thing is that there are scene-safe filters on a channel-by-channel basis, which is huge, because now we can recall scenes and save certain channels as far as scope goes for everything that we want to, and that can be on a channel-by-channel basis. Also, when we're saving the scenes, it can be saved on a channel-by-channel basis as well. Now, all of these upgrades are so worth it, in my opinion. Now, if you want to find out more about the 80-channel expansion, there is a link down in the description below, so you can check that out. But I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the LV1 or a Waves plugin or really anything that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.